So, Doggy Horror Picture Show. Fee Two Spoon. Properly built. Where is the Book of Calm, actually? Would anyone like a book of fun facts? I probably can find my book of facts. Do you have a book of facts? We haven't had a book of facts for a while. Right. Steal it. First of time, yeah, absolutely. Can I have a number between 1 and 323, please? And Blackburn, can I have a number between 1 and 4? Therefore, we have a random book of fact. I haven't found it. Your chat have found it. This only, of course, works if you actually give me a number. I'm not going to be worried about playing not prop rats. Maybe not. Steelit's giving me 147. Blackburn, I need a number, a whole number, between 1 and 4. Or I'll go to the person above you in chat, which is Marzen. So we've got page 147, have I got? Page 147 is, I have found it. Yep. Oh dear. Well, I'm gonna take Distorted second answer, which is 2. Okay. Okay, well, according to my book of fun facts, men's underwater swimming at the 1900 Olympics was never held again due to a lack of spectator appeal. So there you have it. That is your big fact for the morning stream day. And we can all agree that that was a fun fact. And I'm going to try wrestling people on the line. Offending people not on the line. There we go. This is a bizarre setup, but I'll try it. It's evening. What a fact. I know, to be honest. Aardvark, would you like to give me a number between 1 and 323? And we can pull out another fun fact. Did King Casimir III of Poland win the underwater swimming, though? That is the question. I don't know. I went away. Are we playing Brett's for the first time again? No, not again, Ewish. The first time. How do you feel about your phone for a Italian match? I'm excited, Killjoy. I'm absolutely excited. Not particularly, but I know what I was to ask. What is fact number one? That is a great question. Should we have a look and see what the first fact in this book is? I know you're all as excited as me. Fact number one. This is stupid. As if anyone was there to check that. The Big Bang was quieter than a Motorhead concert. So there you go. Oh, this is a good one. The scientist who analysed the plutonium for the first atomic bomb was called Mr. Doom. There you go. Fun fact. Oh, it's fun, isn't it? We like these facts. I know we all like them. I feel like I should get an emote and let you all have the emote. When you want a fun fact, all you have to do is put in the emote in the channel. and then boom, emotes appear. Facts. They just roll off. It'd be classic, Andy, wouldn't it? Oh, who got fame, by the way? Let's look. Did we get fame? No. No, it's a draw. So, right. This is going to be how to play Bretonians. Maybe without them dying. Wouldn't that be fun? he's not here. Fun fact, killer whales are actually dolphins. They are, aren't they? Clever dolphins as well. That's an interesting fact, Hardback. I want to know why someone tested it. Little invented square sausage. Why? That's a Top Gear fact, is it? Well, we've now discovered the Positron Mike and Aardvark may live in the same country. Right, now, how many hits can we get off here? So you can hit you, you can hit you, you can hit you, you can hit you, and with a blitz, you can hit you, which leaves, which gives me 5 hits and no one based at the end of the turn. So the correct route order of doing stuff is therefore this. And this turn, we're about not giving away any major armor 7 hits. So let's start with block. Let's not have him running around doing whatever he wants. Ooh, rando hit. You can blitz here. Haven't left anyone else behind, have we? No. Heart soul, good luck. Fuck that up as well. Well, this is going a bit better, isn't it? This is going alright. Dauntless now. I'll sand you up just in case. Right, well, I have to admit, that was a decent turn. So it turns out, Bretonians, for the first turn, what you need to do is get 2 removals. A bit better. A bit better than generically Marzum. Average. So if you think baseline, no removals, it was a bit better than that. So there we go. Why planning with me getting a job source anyway? Well, yeah. Yeah. How would everyone approach this? I know we can't switch it round like you could in Blood Bowl 1. But what do you guys look at this? Now you're 2 players down. What strategy would you take? Would you try and push really hard down a flank? Would you blitz here and just try and even the numbers back up again? Why? Oh dear. Oh, get the third reroll. Get the third reroll. Right, well, the first thing that's happening is I'm going to block that off. And then we're going to start thinking about the turn a little bit. If you could just take that out, that would give me... doesn't matter. And just for the sake of simplicity, we'll knock you over where you are. And if you went there, you went in as an assist, you blitzed... I don't know where you fall over, because we could get the fend guy on the ball carrier then. So if you go there, that doubles up on that wolf. We need to resolve the rest of this first, because I want to see whether or not we can use one of these to be more aggressive. So let's resolve that. That's a hit. That's so good. Now we just have to do these in sequence. Oh. Oops. So we resolved that by bringing you in here. This would be a massively helpful knockdown. Not quite what I meant. Armor in this is really weak, isn't it? This is the fourth removal, third removal. Do I fancy throwing a one dice or without block against block? Not really. Don't get a ghoul yet. I found when I played the team that having getting the wolves and the whites and the flesh golems, all six of them need skills, so don't level them until you absolutely have to get ghouls, because you don't want to score touchdowns on the ghouls really, and you do want star player points on the flesh golems if you can score with them. Ever score with a flesh golem. Your next order priority would be score the white, because generally scoring with a wolf is easiest. So whenever you're playing Blood Bowl, you should try and score with any player that's difficult to score with, that you want points on. So it's an interesting drive. Both down by two, both down by... I'm down one permanently, he's down two, possibly. Okay. That wolf's in trouble. He's three down for the drive. Oh, yeah, I suppose he is, isn't he? I don't want to offend. Oh, yes. Where's that going? Oh! Oh dear. And a stun. Lovely. We shall return to that shortly. Bizarrely, the first thing to do isn't try and resolve this. It's actually to try and resolve this because they get some more players over here. Hit here. Set both down. And use wrestle. Only a madman wouldn't use wrestle. And then we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I can get you to there and block here. So let's have you there. We can block here. Should use block. And I'll follow that up. Because we use the reroll, I'm not going to block with the player I would have liked to have blocked with. Which was the peasant, to try and set up another go at the surf. Because we use the reroll. What we can now do is. Can you get across? No. Can you get back to the ball? 1, 2. I want the control here because I want that as my out later in the turn. And 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You need to come all the way back. You're going to be the guy that fetches the ball. Walk on the floor. Or knock it out. Bloody hell. Daunt's failed but got away with it because I got block. And then we'll do the same there. And that'll be turn. So. Oh! Has it not updated the title? Oh shit. Didn't, did it? Blood Bowl 2 is Ted. I'm going to Blood Bowl 3. They did announce a Blood Bowl 3 for a little while. Then they decided not to announce Blood Bowl 3 for a little while. So, that happened. We are on turn 4, so statistically speaking, it is the best time to concede. How many removals we had? We've had 4 removals on his... for me against him, and we've suffered a removal. It's a bizarre game. The Blood Bowl 4 hype, yeah. They've actually talked about releasing the trailer for Blood Bowl 5. Alright, you're going there. We're going to just cover the wolf off. If you went there, that white gets up. If you don't go there, it's fine. Do you pick the ball up next? Right, worst case scenario, you go to pick the ball up, you fuck it up. The ball lands there. He dodges out and scores. You go there, you go fuck up the ball, can't pick up. The white isn't going to do anything. So the failure state is better if a guy comes across. In that case, we listen to that. Boom. Got him down. I'd like to try and get this guy. I think we'll just cut there. We'll play this safer then. Right, you're going there, you're going there. That leaves you as the next, almost the next thing to do is that. Then it's this action. And go there. No, there. Push that over. White, stay put. Right, excuse me, an extra player back here. What? Okay, so we've played three games. Sorry, this is our first game of Plutonians, and there's been some really bizarre dice in this game, hasn't there? Look, the ones on YouTube won't know. Don't tell anyone. It's our little secret. It's only 100 of us. It'll be fine. No one will ever find out. And people are returning again. People on YouTube are going, what? Find out about what? And we're like, nothing. Nothing. So, first ever game with Bretonians. Quite like how they're dressed in black. Oh dear. Hello Carly, how you doing? You join us at a particularly tense time where for the very first time I'm playing Bretonians and I've never really played them much before. Far less than you would think. Sadly, Marzum, it doesn't work unless you're a sub, so I'm safe. Safe. Oh, right. And he's never played Blood Bowl before. Yeah. You were hoping for Woody's Bar 7 for this. It's an interesting one. It's an interesting thing. Carly, are you the chap from YouTube that was talking about Wood Elves recently? Are you that person? Right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We could pick the ball up and give it to this chap. Be nice, wouldn't it? I've got a special fondness for anything YouTube based. Now, I need to think about this in terms of who's scoring here. Because do I score with a knight, or do I try and score with a blocker? I think I'm going to score with a knight. I think I would just take a score with a knight. Sounds a bit wrong, doesn't it? Screw the Dauntless, just in case. Yeah. And we'll focus on, because we've got the player advantage now, trying to make sure that we can keep leveraging that where possible. And you can go there. So you're going to pick the ball up. Keep knocking everything over. What? Bretonians have like hidden mighty blow or something. Do they actually have hidden mighty blow? Hidden Mighty Blow, Hidden Stunty. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's probably closest to the truth, isn't it? Resistance is feudal. Oh, yes. That would have been good. My American friend and I are discussing the proper way to say scone. Well, I've covered that. There you go, Rex. If, of course, you are from far north of England, it is scone. But that means it's not there anymore. So what you have, you start with a scone. And then when you finished, it's gone. Okay? Yeah, because you ate it. Absolutely. So, start with a scone, finish with a scone. Okay? I'm bloody Southerners. I live in the middle of the UK. The past tense of scone. Five scones. If, of course, you're assuming that I'm going to eat them. Yeah. You live beyond the wall, though, Chubstep. I know it's only Hadrian's Wall in real life, but you do live beyond the wall. Yeah. Right. Are the dice going to be mean and nasty to me, or not? I think we might be okay here. Don't actually need that dauntless roll. Blockers, pushing them away from the ball carrier at all times, making sure that no one does anything. Wrestling dude done, goes and stands down there. Do we want the wolf running around? I don't feel like I do want this wolf running around. But if I go there, he serves me. So let's just... let's go here. In fact, let's go there. There we go. He's posh. Nottingham confirmed is posh. Wow. Yeah. Are there any other words in the English language like that, where you've got the two different pronunciations of the same word? Because I know scone's one. It's the right way and the wrong way. Oh, yeah. Okay, so there are a couple. Hang on. Right, bath, we can cover that. It's bath, okay? As in, you have a bath. There's no R in bath, so you wouldn't say bath. It's bath. Laugh, yep, bit like bath, but with an L. So that's sorted that out. Grass. Yeah, all right, you could have grass, couldn't you? Grass. Grass. Would possibly accept grass. Graph. I can't think of another way of saying graph. It's just graph. Aunt? No, it's aunt, isn't it? Again, struggling with any other variation of aunt. It's not bath. Or laugh. No. Out. No, it's just out. Some people can't talk properly. Aluminium. Well, Americans have got it called aluminum, haven't they? Because it shines brightly. That's that. Nougat. That's a good one, isn't it? Nougat, nougat. Yeah, we'll have that one. Cat. 10MB, how on earth do you say cat in a different way other than cat? In the north they say hello, the south they don't say anything. Yeah. I don't understand how you would say cat in a different way. Crayon. I'm struggling with a different variation of crayon here. Right, how many can we get rid of in this turn? Because I think there might be one or two here. We open with doors. That gives me some players back. So. Well, that goes there and that blocks that one. But then I'm out of a blitzer. I've got to throw a block without block. So let's do that one to have a go at the blitzer. Yep, that's fine. I can actually follow that up, bizarrely enough. Bay John, welcome to the show. We're trying to work out what different words in English language you can say. That are spelt the same, they just sound, they're pronounced differently. Oh, got one. Oh, red reed. Yeah, that's one, isn't there? Oh, envelope. Yes, J-can, very good. I think envelope's my favourite so far. Playing on the edge of our envelope here. Beach. Oh. Well, there's three surfs. I think I'm going to struggle to keep up with the chat here, so I'm going to need to come back to the chat. I just need to finish my turn. Double skulls on turn 7. Where have we seen that before? Oh my god, are we going to pitch clear a Necro team in our first ever game with Bretonians? Holy shit. I feel like I need to foul here. The chance of getting rid of it. No. I'm not. No, I'm not going to. No. I do not need to foul. I'm playing with my let's get a result head on. And we don't get silly here. We don't get silly. Right, what did I miss? Bijan is an English teacher. Congratulations. Where were you when I was a child? What did you say anyway? I missed what you said. I need to find it. Feline.
Rip BB3.
Oh, as in cat, feline. Yeah, it works. Rama sets tipped up for 20 months. Right, KOs. 2 out of 5. Well, that was a fucking half of Blood Bowl, wasn't it? Hey, Frost. Hello, welcome to the show, by the way. Nice to have you with us. Is it your first time? You nearly joined us when, for the first time, me playing Bretonians, literally for the first time, we nearly pitched clear someone. It's almost like, I feel like Nuffle's just trying to rebalance things a little bit. That was a brutal half, wasn't it? Only side can take a look, one of them that's like Blood Bowl 3. Well, Ramaset, let's consider what we know. So, what do we know about Blood Bowl 3? We know that it's a thing. We know that they're going to re-release the game in 2020. We know that it's going to be in October, if we were a betting person. And that, that we know that there'll be a new rule set, probably fundamentally redesigned. Oh shit, we don't know that yet, do we? If we did know that, that would probably be what had happened. I'm not going to get in so much trouble. Oh, right, anyway. Let's think about this some more. Who do we want to score with? Are any of the blockers on 2 points? So Dauntless can go into that. We can block here. That needs to go there. Really, that needs to go there. That needs to go there. Yeah. Yeah. Both teams lose a turn. I think we're both delighted with that. Right. You can hit that. We've absolutely no idea what Blood Bowl 3 may or may not look like. In its may or may not be finished state. Speculation is futile. And if we can just step forward into this space here, that'd be lovely, wouldn't it? We'll just not take that. And we don't need the Dauntless roll. That's nice, isn't it? Thank God we don't need the Dauntless roll. Yeah. Down there. Right. Now. Do you or do you not fancy stepping into that space there? Oh, he's dropped it. Look, I haven't got a spare reroll to throw at that, so we'll have to let that slide. Homosep says you're playing Brett's before they were deleted for Blood Bowl 3. Oh, I don't know. If I was a betting man, Homosep, I'm sure I'll see Blood Bowl 3 Bretonians. Fortunately for me, I'm actually banned from some betting shops recently. Homosep's about to play Blin Hippie. Oh, best of luck. I don't know about the microtransactions. Knowing what they did, Cyanide did in Blood Bowl 2 with microtransactions, as in they attempted it and fucked it up. You would think that if they play it smart, they will put microtransactions back in, but they will put them in such a way that they don't mess it up this time. because they do seem like a relatively sensible company a lot of the time, and they make a lot of good decisions. So I don't know. We'll see, won't we? We'll see whether or not these microtransactions. I think the best thing to do is think about, take this warm fuzzy feeling that we know that Blood Bowl 3 is coming. Take that, store it somewhere, and revisit it again in 6 months when we'll know more. What the fuck's he got behind you? Only a little bit, because we failed to pick the ball up. I don't know. Right, anyway, back to the Blood Bowl just for a laugh. Let's get rid of that. I wish they all had block. We need to hit that wolf, so you are going to go and deal with the wolf. Do you know what? I'm going to take the free hit on the peasant here. So I can step you. That means I don't need to Dauntless here. And just get that other one back. So. We're both down that. And we can deal with the wolf. Pin it against something we'll defend. Right, so you're going there. You're coming in here. And we can afford to pick ball off. Hooray! And run off all the way over there. So we've left him 4 plus, 2 plus, 2 plus to get a shot on the ball. So let's not do that. We've left him 4 plus, 2 plus, 2 plus to base the ball. That doesn't seem like fun either. Hello, Woodard. How did the Chaos go yesterday? Sadly, they got killed. Like, full-on killed. Bob, what should you play this season? What about an elf team, Bob? Chubstep, don't need to pin it when it's KO'd. Well, that's true. Glad to see you managed to get Brett's your very first game. Yeah, it's going all right, isn't it? It's difficult for it to not go all right when all you roll are powers and tens. That does make the game a bit easier, I found, statistically. V-Spoon has been incredibly unlucky with his inability to stay on the field. Tyranno, is that Brett? I can't believe you're not doing backflips, somersaults and cartwheels down chit-chat about the fact that this is Bretonians. And you've just joined us at our first ever game, Tyranno. Who knew? You have been stunned repeatedly. I mean, in our first game, it would just be surprising. Hello, Aramisin. How you doing? We're a little bit out of position considering we're players up. Yeah, we'll rest there. Oh. And he's just dicing a view. Yeah. And last time I was here, I was on the top of the list. Aromacin, where were you actually? How long ago, Aromacin? And I'll tell you what happened. I think you have been a player on the team recently. I think it went well as well. And welcome back. Nice to have you with us again. Any other safe moves we want to do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I want that, so let's try and knock this white over. We'll double pin it instead. We'll do the same job. Actually, will we double pin it? Because, yeah, we will. We will double pin it because it's one of his agility 3 players. Blitz is going to be there. So actually the blitz is the next thing to do because we don't know what's going to happen here. Stay put. And then bravely run away. I know where that's from. Thingy Bob bravely ran away. Away, away. So that's pinned, that's double roll for it. Don't miss roll. Then we can score next time. There we go. Terrano, I suppose I'm not on the team. Don't know. Marsum says the perfect Brett team is 4-4-6. What, as in record-wise, Marsum? Oh, you mean as in build. You don't mean record. I couldn't tell you maybe 3 or 4 weeks back. 3 or 4 weeks back, Aromacin, would be probably the Chaos team. But I don't remember you being a Chaos player. Like, genuinely don't remember you being on the Chaos team. Yes. Brave Sir Robin ran away, away. Do you know what? We need some Monty Python clips. Can anyone find it on YouTube? Just some like short Monty Python clips so we can play them and I'll put them into Zunkbot and we'll have them as little catchphrases and stuff. And we could have that. I think that'd be quite interesting. Can we come up with some Monty Python clips that work for this team so we can play them on specific things? So when we need to run away, we've got that. Because I think that would be quite entertaining. Oh, Jesus Christ, oh, when something outrageous happens. Is there anything that you could relate to? I haven't watched it enough. You guys probably know it far better than I do. Because unless it's a trap, I haven't seen it. What's that?
What you got there? Jesus Christ!
Okay. Oh, bloody peasant for when things go wrong when a blockade lets us down.
Oh, but if I went round saying I was an emperor just because some moistened bint had lobbed a scimitar at me, they put me away! Shut up! Will you shut up? Ah! Now we see the violence inherent in the system! Shut up! Oh, come and see the violence inherent in the system! Help! Help! I'm being repressed! Bloody peasant! Oh, what a giveaway! Did you hear that? Did you hear that, eh?
Bloody, right. I'll clip the bloody peasant bit. Yeah, I'll clip that. We'll get that in. Bloody peasant. Help, I'm being repressed. Oh, that's brilliant. That'll do. Oh, she got.
Look, just a flesh wound.
Yes, that's when you get casualty. Right. Thank you, Marzim. Well, I'll throw him to the floor for when you need to roll a pal. I'll go through that. It will delay the next guide video slightly, but we'll get that. Oh, throw him to the floor for a fail. Go for it, yeah. If anyone, by the way, feels like they want to just edit a video sound file out or anything like that and send it me on Discord, I'll put the credit of whoever does it into the chat on Zunkbot. So if there's any budding sound effects artists or anything, it's actually Muggins here can do it, so it isn't that difficult. But there's you guys, between there's 120 of you, you might actually come up with things that I miss. Right, is there anything I'd want to hit? Well, you're on 2 points and you're on no points. So if we do, you stand up and you punch something. If the MVP lands on you, it causes a casualty. Next guy video. Marzen, what you link me there? I'm actually just leaving these links open.
Bring out Shadeen! Bring out Shadeen!
Bring out your dead. Yeah. Soundbites are called it a draw. I think at this point we put cannon fodder on the line. Sure, I might what you've got.
He's buggered off, so he has his scarf on.
Brave got off and ran away.
No!
Bravely ran away.
wait, is BB3 a real thing? Evan Rolf, hello. Let me get this right. Blood Bowl 3. If you wound time back 24 hours, absolutely was a real thing, and Cyanide did announce it. They also announced at the time there would have been a new tabletop game, and they didn't announce it would be in October. If you fast forward 24 hours, they then withdrew that statement and said none of the above. So it depends where we are in the timeline. Yeah, so if you knew about it, you need to forget you knew. And if you were a streamer, you might have remembered to actually update the stream title. However, since I'm bringing you up to speed, we'll tell you about the timeline. So now you know that you now need to forget that Blood Bowl 3 is a thing. So there you go.
All right, we'll call it a draw.
Yeah. So, if you were American and lived under the Trump administration, you could call it fake news. That's a thing, X-Holes. Been had. It depends who you listen to. 10 MB. Is it megabytes or megabits, or does it mean something else? Treat Blood Bowl 3 like pass block or diving tackle. Well, hang on. One of them skills is shit, and one of them isn't better than you-ish. I don't know, Gunner 023. I think 102 would be considered a not a great start. But 100, that is a start, isn't it? That's the sort of start if you were a fresh, budding Bretonian coach starting out in life, having never played Bretonians before. You'd be happy with that, wouldn't you? Oh, ladies and gentlemen, we have Sage joining us there with the host. Thank you very much, Sage. How are you doing tonight? We are playing our first ever game with Bretonians. And it's a thing. It is absolutely a thing. Bretonians are quite an entertaining team, aren't they? Start boxing off these cage corners. He's got to do something here. It's even though it's written as 10 megabits. Yeah. Who did it? Oh no, that's not a time to throw that sort of bomb. Exodite, Troglodyte, welcome. DNR, yeah, so what had happened in the Blood Bowl 3 announcement? Was that they announced more than they should have announced, and therefore they had to retract the announcement in its entirety. Or they chose to retract it in its entirety. I don't know if they needed to. They did. Dice are being tinkerish, aren't they? Where's the ball going? Huh. Good square. I think you throw one dice here so you can get through. pick it up. Will I throw it now? Catch, fantastic. And Dr. Nick's on 5 points. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Nick, congratulations. If BB3 doesn't have corn, I'm gonna cry. If I was a betting man, and we have established earlier in the show that I'm not allowed to be a betting man, I would think that corn would be around. In fact, if I was a betting man, I would predict that Chaos Pact will also be there. Relatively lucky there. Doig works for Blood Bowl. Doig works for Blood Bowl, does he? Fantastic. Do you actually work for Blood Bowl, Doig? Fahrenheit, welcome to the show. We are playing our first ever game of Bretonians. Yeah, there's a lot of Oh, 10MB does work for Blood Bowl. Okay. First ever game Bretonians said no one ever. Oh, come on. This is our first ever game Bretonians. We took a couple of games where we tried the skins out and didn't like them. We tried purple, didn't suit us. We tried blue, it didn't suit us. We played in black. It works. Yeah. So, look, you're allowed to try different skins, aren't you? Indeed. Yeah, black's all right. I think you will be... seeing microtransactions in the form of customizable skins, as in letting you change the color of your team after each game, like you could in Blood Bowl 1, and then giving you the different color palettes and all the rest of the fun stuff that goes along with it. Nasha, that's an oldie but a goodie. I'd pay for random bits of artwork on the team because it would make the team look different. Distort, we don't talk about that. Rename Journeyman. I think they should give you that as a thing, to be fair. Buy a reroll for $9.99. I don't think that's going to happen. Conspiracy theory, Blood Bowl 3 is released and intentionally leaked. I would say that Blood Bowl 3 is a thing, and I think they fucked up the announcement and had to retract it. I think it is a thing. If they're in the development cycle and they are thinking of pulling it back with only a year to go, I reckon they've probably got most of a working prototype of Blood Bowl. 10MB can probably tell us more. Over to you, 10MB. They're going to go straight to Blood Bowl 4. Dioig, we got to Blood Bowl 5 in the chat earlier. Well, for everyone. Well, oh, he's got the pass. Beautiful. Beautiful. On a white as well, that's good. It's So, V-Spoon, if you're watching the game back, thank you very much. It was a good game. It's difficult to say a lot because they got such good casualty dice in the first half. How'd you go wrong with that? It was just a silly game. Do we want to re-roll that? Yeah, we do. No, we don't. Moving on. And Sky Blue Monty picked up the MVP. Interesting. So we did throw 60 blocks. That's quite a lot of blocks. And off 60 blocks, we got 13 armor breaks. And off 13 armor breaks, we got 9 removals. So the 13 armor breaks into 9 removals is way higher than it should be. 60 blocks into that many removals? No, we were lucky. We were just lucky. Oh yeah, we should have bought the APO, shouldn't we? Oh well. So, right. Oops, wrong player. That's not one that leveled up. Heart Soul rolls. A normal skill. It feels like the right thing to do is take leader. Because a third reroll would be quite nice. It does feel like leader would be the right thing to do. But I'd rather, as Spuddy has said, I think dodge is the pick I'm going to take. Because I don't think I want to run. Well, hang on. Do I want to run leader? Period. Do I want to run leader? Let's think about this. Go back. So look at the team. Look at the team build. So for 990, if you add a apothecary in there and two more linemen, you're looking at a base team value of about 1150. Put another 10 fan factor on. So 1250 all in, and the rest is then skills. And you could play with 12 at the lower team value. So you're looking at 1200 without any stuff on top of it. That means you've got 10 skills to play around with, which is one skill per player, and a couple of players get two skills. And you're still at 1400, which is where you would want to play at. So you could have Blodge and Leader. You have Dodge, 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 God, 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 God. Three rerolls. You could do that. I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to go leader. I am going to play leader. There we go. I'd say frenzy since you love to pick pieces off the pitch. Yeah. So, we're going to go that. We're going to go with leader. So what we will do then is I think I'm going to probably skill these three. Dodge, dodge, dodge. The leader gets to carry the ball because it's good protection for him and he now needs dodge. So they go dodge is their next skill. A couple of them would get tackle. These guys are all going to go guard. And I'm probably going to go guard, stand firm, bizarrely. I am unsure whether we will even build a killer on this team. Because they're going to dodge and sidestep. And then you've got four sidestep, four guard, four stand firm. I think that might be interesting. It might be an interesting way of playing it.